If you'd like to work along with me, I'm going to put the document I started with out on the web page. I'll put it under the video tutorials, and then I'll put an Office Writer right below that. Please give me a couple of days to get it out there. Let's take a look at the formatting toolbar. That's the second toolbar down. And we're going to skip these first two for the moment and start with this font name. The font type here, style, is the type of text written, and the 12 is the font size. Let's try a different one and see how we get a little sample of how they look when we click this drop down. Let's pick some show card Gothic and change the size to 18. So, nice different style. There's all kinds of different styles of fonts to choose from. Now, to get back to where we were, I would need to go back down to Times New Roman and change that back to 12. So now we're back to our default size. Let's take a look at what some of those other buttons are. Now, I've just pasted some text in here, and we'll learn about that in a moment. First, let's get into what the buttons are. We've got, to make this bold, I'm highlighting by left-clicking on the mouse and just dragging over it to highlight it, which is actually selection. Selecting is the proper term. And I'm going to click on this bold button, and it bolds it. Another way to do this is to double-click on the word, and it selects it or highlights it, but selecting is the proper term. Clicking to italicize. And then the underline is similar to what we did with the text. If I delete it, I'm using my delete button. And now I'm going to click the underline, which turns it on, and I'm going to type underline. And you can see the button's clicked. I'm going to click it off. And when we click on italic, our italic button is shown. And when I click on the bold, see the bold button is shown. And to turn on all three, I'm going to just highlight again, or select. And now I'm going to click the bold, and the italic, and the underline. So this has all three in one. And I can turn them all on and off once the text is selected. Our next buttons along the top are the align left, which is the default here. Then our align center. And to do that, I just click on the line and click the button, and this is centered. Then to align right, I click the align right. The next button is justified. We're going to skip this one for now. Okay, our next button, numbering on off. If we have a list here, like I have a few things to do and I want to do them in order, so I'm going to highlight them and I click on the numbering on, and they're numbered. I have the same list I'm going to highlight, and this time I don't want them numbered. I just want them to be bullet items. And there we have it, bullet items. Now, to increase the indent, decrease it. See, I can even take it outside of the margin. Let me bring that back, and I can keep going to increase it. And now we're going to reset it back to where it was. Our next one is the font color. Let's change the font color of this line right here. We click on this down arrow and then pick the color that we want our selected line to be. So we'll make it turquoise. So the font is changed to turquoise. Now, these next two buttons, we've got highlighting and background color. To see the difference between those two, we're going to take this first example and going to highlight that, and we're going to make it yellow. Now, this second example, we're going to use the background color and turn that yellow. So that shows you the whole section is changed color, whereas when we're highlighting, it's only behind the letters that is highlighted. And the last thing I want to talk about right now is the undo. And the undo is if you do something by accident, like we didn't want to change those colors, we click the undo. And if we click this arrow down, we can see almost all the changes I've made. And we can skip back as many as we want, but we need to do them in order. We can't skip back and unbold this without undoing the underlining that we did after. So there's some good and bad. And then this arrow is the redo. I'll also mention that the edit button's where we find our undo and redo, and we can see Control Z, that will also work, is the undo, and Control Y is the redo. And all these shortcut buttons will be found in the menu bar.